Professor Dave again, let's talk about greatest common factors.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just learned about least common multiples. These can be found when comparing two numbers and finding the smallest number that is a multiple of both of them. By the same token, we will want to be able to identify the greatest common factor of two numbers. As you might be able to guess, this is the largest number that is a factor of both the numbers. Take, for example, 10 and 15. If we write out all the factors, for 10, that would be 1, 2, 5, and 10. For 15, that would be 1, 3, 5, and 15. The largest number that can be found in both of these lists is 5. So 5 is the greatest common factor of these two numbers. Now let's try 18 and 24. Here are all the factors for both of these numbers, and we will find that 6 is the largest factor that is common to both lists. So 6 is the greatest common factor of 18 and 24. Just like with the least common multiples, this is easy to do for small numbers because they will have only a handful of factors, so we can just list them all and compare. But again, as numbers get larger, it may become tedious to identify and list every single factor for a number. So there is a bit of a trick to this as well. Let's look at the same example we just did. We can carry out the prime factorization of both numbers, and that would give us 2 times 3 times 3, and 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. Once we have this, all we do is take all the numbers that appear in both lists, as many times as they appear in both of the lists, and multiply them together. So this first 2, that's in both, so let's pull that aside. This 3, that's also in both, so let's pull that aside as well. Now we are done, because one list has a 3 left and no 2s, and the other list has some 2s but no 3s. Now we take the 2 and 3 we pulled aside and multiply them together to get 6, which we already knew was the answer. This works because if we take all of the prime factors present in both lists, they must necessarily give a product that is a factor of both numbers. And with no more prime factors left in common to multiply, this will necessarily be the greatest common factor. Let's try the same thing for 24 and 108. For 24, let's chop that up into 12 times 2, the 12 into 4 times 3, and the 4 into 2 times 2. That gives us 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. For 108, let's cut it in half. Cut the 54 in half, cut the 27 into 3 and 9, and 9 into 3 and 3. That gives us 2 times 2 times 3 times 3 times 3. Now we see what we have in both lists. We take one of the 2s, another 2, and a 3, and that's all we can do. So 2 times 2 times 3 is 12, and that's the greatest common factor for these two numbers. This technique is reliable no matter how big the numbers get, so it eventually becomes a much better strategy than listing all the factors and examining the lists. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.